Hi, I'm Johnny, and this is Comics Altruism, back from the dead. One of the members of our community, it's not so much that he's in a bad way, but his brother is in a bad way. And even though we're here in Canada, where our universal medicine helps to kind of absorb some of that extra stress. So I took out a whole bunch of stuff right here just because I'm not sure how personal I'm allowed to be. Plus, like, I'm bringing this to you, and I wouldn't do that if I didn't feel that it was important and justifiable as a fundraiser. So, yeah, just trust me on this one, I guess. And I don't want to, like, expose him or, like, all of his personal stuff. So anyway, I've got the first week's worth of eBay books here. The link will be down below. If you see anything you're interested in, bid it up hardcore. A lot of this stuff is unfortunately like mid-grade, like the good stuff is mid-grade, and then the, you know, not so great as far as minor keys or whatever. They happen to be high grade, like this one, for instance. This one got some heat a little while ago. It's the, you know, because Michael Keaton's going to be in the, what is it, Flashpoint, I think? I don't know, I'm totally out of the loop. So I got that one at a 9.6, which is awesome. The next six are going to be sold as a set. So we've got number 408 of Batman. It's 9.2. It's the first Maw gun. We've got this retelling of the Jason Todd origin in the next couple issues. Those are both, well, the first one there was 9.4 to 9.6. This one is really low grade. It's like a 3.5 to a 4.0, which is kind of why I'm selling it as a set. And then there's, yeah, just that's the continuation of the Two-Face story. That's an 8.0. We got the first appearance of Mime here, and that's at like a 9.0. And then just because, number 413 as well. Nothing special about that one. Next up, we've got first appearance of Tim Drake. That's in relatively high grade, like a 9.4. This is a good one. All right, so we've got the first cameo appearance of Damian Wayne. I want to say I got that from Farley's Nerd Cave way back when. Don't quote me on that. Either way, like, that's a high-value book, and it's in a high grade. I got it as a 9.4. Number 658, going with that one, just because it's, like, a minor key in the whole Damian Wayne story. So those are going together. Got Detective 608, First Appearance of Anarchy. I have no idea why, but I had, like, three copies of this book, so I've kind of been selling one for every time that I hold a fundraiser or whatever. Then we've got Detective 881. The only reason that was worth anything is just because of the jock cover. So, like, there's nothing significant about the story or anything. Next up, oh, this is a good one. Okay, so Batman, number 89. You remember how that exploded? First appearance of Punchline. And so I got the Matina variant here, which is worth significantly more than any of the subsequent printings. I think the cover A of first print is worth more than that one. Don't quote me on that. Either way, that should bring in a pretty penny, I'm thinking. I'm hoping. And then this number 90, just to add that to it. Got Green Lantern number 49 and 50 from way back in 1994. So those are, well, the first one is high grade. Second one was, what do I have that as? 7.0, because there's the back cover is kind of messed up. Either way, it's the first Kyle Rayner as Green Lantern. Not hoping for too much with that one. Emerald Dawn number 1, just because I've only got number 1, so why not try to get rid of it? And don't lose your shit when you see this one, because it's the facsimile edition. I would not be selling that, I don't think, for anything. Well, maybe if it was like a cure for cancer or something. Anyway, yeah, facsimile edition, it's high grade. Just because a lot of people miss that one, surprisingly. So even though Comic Book Realm doesn't have it as a super high valuable book, I know that a lot of people were seeking it out. So there's your chance. I'm going to have it at a nice low starting bid. Along with most of this stuff, it's going to be a reasonable starting bid. I'm not going to go crazy, except for like that first appearance at Damian Wayne, because I can't risk selling that for like a dollar. We got Cobra number 1, just for fun. Got Justice League number 58, low grade, but you can't go wrong with 1969. Classic. Moving on to, oh yeah, so these Man-Bat comics are also quite low grade, but for some reason, in higher grade, they're worth a fair bit. I'm wondering if it's just because they're low print run or something. But either way, Man-Bat 1 and 2 are going together. And we got New Teen Titans Annual number 2. There is, oh yeah, there's like three first appearances in this one. We've got First Vigilante, First Cheshire, and First Lila Michaels. Gotta be honest, I haven't read that one, so I don't even know who those characters are. What kind of nerd am I, right? We got Showcase number 80. That's the first Silver Age appearance of Phantom Stranger. Also happens to be a Neil Adams cover, so those are always good to have. 4.5. So, I mean, considering 1969, that's not terrible. Shazam number 15. It's a 100-page giant. We got, oh yeah, so this is going to be like a pretty big set. So we've got 7 comics here. I just kept it simple. So there's Superman, Batman number 1, and I'm not going to take these back out. Numbers 2 through 7. Another one of those, not really having any reason to put it up, but it's here anyway. Tales of the Green Lantern Corps number 1. Again, because I only have number 1, so why not get rid of it? Tales of the Teen Titans Annual number 3, which I think, again, its only significance is the fact that it's Judas Contract part 4. And then we've got Warlord number 1. I got that in 7.5, the second appearance of Warlord, obviously the first in his own title. Never read that one either. But that's for all you fantasy lovers out there. It's from 1976. And lastly, Wonder Woman number 9. That's the origin of Cheetah from 1987. Yeah, 87. There's some deep problems with this one, though, so I've got it at like a 6.5, 7.0, something like that. So we're going to see how first week goes. I just lost my only day off this week, so I don't think I'm going to have enough time to prep for next week. But like the original plan was to go all through June. So I guess depending on the success we have with this, I might wait for 2 weeks, maybe do a Marvel, because that was all DC, maybe do a Marvel week and see how that goes, see if I'm content with what we're able to raise for them. So yeah, I guess that's it for now. Thanks for watching. Check out the eBay auction. Link is down below. Let's hope we get some bids. All right, bye.